Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be doing a rapid-fire SketchUp Q&A. Okay, so on Reddit, there was someone who asked a bunch of questions relating to a particular project, and so I figured if you're going through a project like this, you may questions come up like this all the time, and some of these are fairly small, so if you're an advanced SketchUp user or even intermediate, these may seem pretty elementary answers, but I figured if anyone is new to SketchUp or just hasn't run into these, it would be helpful to just know the answers. So this particular user asks, basically they got this file, they can't extrude these shapes. Now the thing to, I'm just going to draw a shape really quick. The thing to know about SketchUp, so let's say this is our shape, just drawing a weird shape. You see that this will make a face and then fills that in with gray. If you import, let's say, a DWG from a separate file, what will happen is that it'll look like this. So there's no fill in this. So the way that you fix that is you can actually close this. If you just draw over that line again, it'll close it and then fill in that shape. So that will then allow you to push pull. So then if you hit P on your keyboard, it'll give you this little symbol here. And then you can just select that face and move it in the direction that you want. However, in this instance, for our user, there may be just too many to retrace all of those lines. So what you can do is I have an extension installed called Nroth Face Creator. So you can see if I go to extensions and then come down here and just click that, it fills in the face. So let's say, you know, I have another face over here, something a little bit wonkier, do this, go to extensions, Nroth Face Creator, and it will fill both of those faces in as long as they're a closed shape. On to the second question. How do I delete an entire 3D shape instead of one panel at a time? So this is pretty simple. Let's say we extruded this up like this, and he's just going through and deleting like this. If you actually, that's a single click, so it selects the face. If you double click on a face, it will select the face and its binding edges. And if you triple click, so 1, 2, 3, it will select all of the connecting faces. This is where you need to be very careful about using groups. If you're doing like individual buildings like this, it may make sense to make each one a group so that like when you start putting in roads or any sort of ground, it doesn't select everything because it will select everything that's connected. So there's an answer to that question. Here's another question. The user asks that he's accidentally push-pulled 3 times, and you can see here that there's 3 different lines here, and he's asking how to get rid of them. So I don't know exactly. You can see here we've already extruded this once. If I hit P and then go again, it doesn't make another line. However, if you do press Control, it will make another line. So I'm not sure if that's what he did here or what. Let's say, yeah, I don't know exactly how this happened, but sometimes it does. So if you, let's say you have something like this, what you can do, or what I like to do, is select this face, and I'm going to hit Control X to cut, and then select this face here. If it's sort of like that, what he was experiencing. If not, you can always double click this, and it'll delete those lines as well. So the difference between that is the first click, I was just selecting the face. And then with the double click, I'm selecting the face and its binding edges. And it will select all of those things. And then to get my top back on, you could either draw the line or with some more complex geometry, I just go to edit, paste in place, and it's back. And our third and final question is, why do some of my shapes remain purple after being push-pulled? Now you can see his style is a little bit different than mine, and I actually, for the longest time, had no idea. Mine is sort of like a gray and a white, but if I look at one of these, is the purple. We'll find it. Okay, so what I've done here is I've extruded this other shape here, and you can see that there's a clear difference in the color between this one and this one. This is a white and this is a gray. Now what I've done, I couldn't find the exact style, but basically he's using a particular style that makes sort of like the purple reverse edges. So I made a similar one. So if I just, on the right hand side where it says styles, I just click that guy. And you can see that this face is purple and this one is white. Although they're exactly made the same, there's no materials applied or anything. Just really quickly, the way that these show up is that there's a front face and then a back face. So in your style, if you want to change that, it's helpful to do this if you're like rendering or anything. And there's some other things you can use it for. But if you go to edit, there's this, and then you select this little face setting here. There's a front color and a back color. So right now we have that little purple selected. The front color is white. So the way that you fix that is basically you select on the face that you want to change. In this case, it's this entire shape. So what you do is triple click into that, right click, and then go to reverse faces, and it will change that to white. So basically, if I delete this, you can see the inside is actually that purple color, and the outside is white. So hopefully that gives a little bit of clarity about what is going on there. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.